And probability has got a simple formula, or rather you can calculate the probability of any event using a formula. And the formula is that the probability of any event is equal to the number of possibilities meeting the condition. Or we can say the number of favorable outcomes over the over the total number of possibilities. Okay? Or the number of all the possible outcomes. Right? This we can simplify mathematically and write this like how you're doing in grade 10 and grade 11. The probability of an event E is equal to the number of favorable outcomes, which will be the number of possibilities for a particular condition. This will be divided by the total number in the sample space. And the sample space is the total number of all the possible outcomes. Okay? So we use this formula. Now, be aware that the probability of an event is between 0 and 1. Okay? The probability of any event is between 0 and 1. You cannot calculate a probability and get an answer which is more than 1 or which is negative. The answer has to be between 0 and 1. Okay? So you did that in grade 10. You also did that in grade 11. Now we are going to incorporate the counting principle to the calculation of probabilities of different situations with regard to the counting principle. So you need to know that formula because we are going to use it. Right? So always, when you are doing calculations of probability and the counting principle, you need to determine what is your NF, what is the total number of possible outcomes. Okay? You also need to determine what is the number of possible outcomes for a specific condition, or what is the number of, or rather, the favorable outcome? No. Then diagram, that's grade 11. Okay. Right. Don't confuse the counting principle and the grade 11 probability. Grade 11 probability, you did that last year, end of last year. I might refresh you sometime this week, but it is assumed that you are in grade 12 now. We did that at the end of last year. Right? I'm not obligated to do it. Okay? Alright. So let me turn to an example on probability under the counting principle. I still have to start that one too. All right, so let me carry on to an example. Now, let's do this question. Right, the question says, consider the word careful, right? The first part says, how many ways can the letters of this word be arranged? So, A1, number of ways. Alright, if you have got 7 letters, it means you have got 7 positions. So the number of ways that these letters can be arranged can be 7 factorial, which is 5040. Right? Then number 2 says, if the letters of the word are arranged randomly, calculate the probability that the resulting word will start with R and end with U. Okay? So this is now our second part of the question. Now, first thing, if we want to calculate the probability that the word is going to start with R and end with a U, we need to know what is the total number of all the possible outcomes. That number we represented by NS, and it's going to be equal to 5040. Because with the first part of the question, we are saying the letters can be arranged in any way. There is no specific what? Restriction. Okay? So the total number of words is going to be 5040 if there is no restriction. Okay? There is no restriction. Any letter can take any position. But of course, the letter cannot be repeated because we only have 7 what? Letters. So the total number of possible outcomes will be 7 factorial, which is 5040. That's our NS, that will be our denominator,
when you are calculating the probability.
Then we need to know now what are the number of words that can be formed if the first letter is R and the last letter is a U. So in that case, number of words if word starts with R and ends with U. This will be equal to, now that situation is gonna be like this. So we've got 7 position, 4, 5, 6, 7. So you're gonna have an R there, and then you're gonna have a U. So that's fixed. Then here you can have the other 5, then 4, 3, 2, 1. So the answer is gonna be 1 times 5 factorial times 1, which gives you 120. Right? Therefore, the probability, okay, I'll say P, where it starts with R, and ends with a U. That probability is going to be 120 over 5040. It gives you what? 120 over 5040? 1 over 42. Okay, so that will be your probability. So first thing, you must determine your total number of all the possible outcomes. Then you need to determine the number of favorable outcomes, or the number of, the number of possibilities for that specific condition. And then you divide the two. Yes. Okay. The question says, if the letters of the word are arranged randomly, calculate the probability that the resulting word will start with R and end with a U. How many R's do we have? How many U's? One. So the first position, this R here means we are referring, that's a one. It's one R. The last one is a one U. Only an R can be here, and only a U can be there. But the other 5 positions can have the other letters. So what's the total number of ways? It's going to be 1 times 5 factorial times 1, which gives you 120. Are you following? Are you following?
Yes.
I'm sure you can agree with me that for the first one, okay, for the first one, that is number one, 7 factorial is the total number of ways, or rather, yeah, that's the total number of ways, right? Because there is no restriction in number one. Okay? If there is no restriction, then you get the total number of all the possibilities. In the second question, there is a restriction, which means you get less. Okay? So we are saying the first letter is R, the last letter is a U. How many ways? You fix the R, you fix the U first. Then the other letters can be rearranged. But you can't rearrange the U and the R. Because they are fixed based on the question. The question says the word will start with R and it will end with a U. That's a restriction.
So it's just like before with the graphic. You know, they put 1, then 5 exclamation points and another 1.
Yes.
I mean, before.
Yeah.
Easier.
The concept the concepts we did in the past few days, they still apply here. Then B says, consider the word dangerous, right? How many ways can the letters of the word be arranged How many ways can the letters of the word be arranged? Right? So here we have got how many letters? 10. Right?
Nine.
Right? So B1, so there are 9. The total number of ways is going to be 9 factorial.
Yes.
So that would be 9 factorial. What is 9 factorial?
3, 6, 2, 8,
0. So that's 362,808 like that, right? Then the next question says, if the letters of the word are arranged randomly, what is the probability that the resulting word will start with the letters D-A-N in this order? Now, D-A-N, it means the first three letters are fixed. They have to start with D-A-N-N-N, right? So, number two, number of ways such that the word starts with D-A-N. Okay, this will be equal to. Now, let me explain this part. Okay, I think I can do it here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right? So the word has to start with the D, A, and then N. Which means D will occupy this position, A will occupy that position, and N. Because it says in this order. If it was in any order, that is, either you can have A and D and then N, or N here, D here, and then A, it will be slightly different. But in this case, the first position must have a D, the second an A, and the third must have an N. Right? Then the remainder, that is the other six, six can take that one, then 5, and 4, 3, 2, then 1. Alright? So the number of we cannot say 3 factorial because there has to be in that specific order. So that's fixed. So it will be 1 times 6 factorial.
Yes.
Which is 720.
Yo.
Okay? If they could be arranged in any order, but they occupy the first three positions, then you could put 3 factorial in. But you can't put 3 factorial because they are fixed. Okay? The D, the A, and the N are fixed. They have to take specific positions. Then our total number in the sample space, the answer we got in the first part, which is 362,880. So the probability, okay, P, where it starts with D A N. Yes. The probability that the word starts with D A N is going to be equal to 720 over P62880.
One over five and three.
Right.